A mystery package from Leszek Sikon. You know what's funny? When I asked him what's in the package, he told me a knife. So not only is he a world-renowned blacksmith already, he's also a comedian. What's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Frank Owalo, and this channel is all about knife knowledge, reviews, unboxings, and head-to-heads. And today, we are unboxing a mystery package from Leszek Sikon. For those of you who don't know who he is, Leszek is originally from Poland. He's been living in Suffolk, United Kingdom for roughly a decade and a half. And he is, I'd like to consider him quite new in the blacksmithing, knifesmithing world, but already he has made a name for himself. He got a Bachelor's of Arts in blacksmithing somewhere around 2016, I think, 2017. He's already been awarded some prestigious awards, one of them being the Quest Award, which is the Queen Elizabeth Scholarship Trust in 2020. So this guy is no joke. He might be new-ish to the scene, but everyone knows about him. He sells his knives at some of my favorite shops across the globe. Eating tools, modern cooking, Chef's Edge. He always has some really cool handled knives at Chef's Edge. He's also on many YouTube channels featured on UK Blade Show. I'm not sure what's in here, and we're going to dive into this unboxing real quick, but when I think of Leszek, three characteristics of his blades come to mind. The first one is Graphite series. So I believe it's spicy white core, then you have a layer of nickel, which really stops that carbon diffusion. Essentially what that just means is no migration of atoms from the steel above that or below it. So you get this nice crisp silver line amongst this very nicely etched steel. And I believe above that might be O1 or other variations of layered steel typically. The second thing when I think of Leszek is integral bolster. Some of the coolest integral bolsters I've seen, because they very much look like they're handmade, they're textured, they're beautiful. I'd love to see how they feel in hand. So again, not sure what's in here other than I actually do know it's a Gyuto. I saw that in the customs declaration form, so now I know it's a knife and likely a Gyuto. And third, when I think of Leszek, I think of his handles, but specifically there's been one I've obsessed with over probably about a year, year and a half, and it's his Live Edge handles. He sells, again, some of those I've seen a lot at Chef's Edge. One of my buddies has them as well and just raves about it. I can also think that maybe in here is a scrappy boy, so this is when he's forging a blade and maybe the length's not quite what he wanted it to be. He doesn't quite have the quality materials that he wanted to have. Well, rather than throw it away after all that hard work, he creates what he called the scrappy boys. And here's a picture up on screen. I believe he's released two batches to date, maybe a third. So again, not only is this guy super well known already across the globe, receiving many prestigious awards like the Quest Award, but the fact that I've already told you that when I think of him, there's three unique characteristics that come to mind. And if you've noticed, they affect the blade, the middle of the blade, the bolster, and the handle. So that is one heck of a way of already making your mark into the scene, when someone can see the blade, the bolster, or the handle and say, that is a Leszek Sikon knife. And again, sorry if I'm not saying your family name right. Maybe I'll just stick to Leszek. I feel like I'm saying that more properly. So without further ado, we are going to dive right in to see what is in this box. We won't be doing any performance tests today. There will likely be a knife review video aside from this unboxing. But for now, we just want to see what's in it. I will say one thing, the size of the box is scaring me a little bit. Because anything above 25 centimeters, 250 millimeters as a Gyuto, I don't think I can handle really well. And this is a long box. Now, I know that there are many smiths out there, shops that just kind of have a one-size-fits-all type of box. One such scenario, I believe, would be, say, Peter from Modern Cooking with Birch and Bevel. Very large boxes, but I think they fit just about anything he needs to fit in there. So maybe that's the case, but I also know at the beginning of December 2023, he had made some really long, big, bad boy Gyutos. We're talking above 25 centimeters. So maybe that's one of these. I don't think it's gonna be Damascus. So actually, before we unbox, what do I think is in here? It's a knife. It's a Gyuto. It might be above 25 centimeters. I doubt it's gonna be Damascus. I do think he's gonna have his classic integral bolster, and I don't think it's going to be a Live Edge handle. So potentially maybe it's even a prototype he wants me to test, but I'm not sure. So what do you say we dive right in and we'll come back to see my first impressions.
Okay.
Holy smokes, I now own a Leszek knife. A few things. I said Graphite series. Boom. Bingo. We were right on the money about the Graphite series being something that I not only recognize as being a Leszek owned product, but that's what we got, which is freaking fantastic. I cannot tell you how beautiful this black beauty is in front of me. The integral bolster, nailed it. Just a black on black, the handle feels very raw. I'm definitely going to be moisturizing it because here in Edmonton it's very dry and I don't believe it, no, it's definitely not stabilized. Now what I think is that this knife is probably a knife that just didn't meet Leszek's quality control. There's, say, the unevenness or the unfinished nickel cladding line. To me, this is a very raw blade. It always kills me when I see blacksmiths making a product that maybe doesn't meet their standards, and I get it. You need to try to aim and achieve a certain standard so that you can sell it on the market and it represents you well. But I think Leszek did something very smart, which was say, I think someone across the pond is going to appreciate this, use this, and I'm still going to make a great performance video about this knife. I think it sits at roughly 25 centimeters, as you saw, when I compared it to the Takamura Uchigomo no Hana 24 centimeter Gyuto. This feels great in hand. Its balance point is going to be right about the pinch grip, which is freaking fantastic. Great unboxing experience. I'm gonna be honest, I'm typically not a fan of these Kiri style boxes just because they feel very rough, but his is polished. It's stained. It's smooth on the hands. Absolutely loved this box. I love the color too. It's a really nice, deep, rich, almost cherry quality to it. I love his logo. I think it's very classy looking. I love it stamped into the blade. Just absolutely gorgeous. Leszek, thank you so much. Guys, thank you for accompanying me in this mystery unboxing. Please check out his socials. You can find him on Instagram. He has his own website. Again, you can find his knives on Eating Tools, Modern Cooking, Chef's Edge, to name a few. You'll find videos about him in mini-style documentaries on YouTube. One such channel will be UK Blade Show. They did a great feature on him. This is incredible, Leszek. Thank you so much for the opportunity to play with one of your knives. I'm gonna go upstairs right now and moisturize this bad boy. Black on black, how sexy is that? Thank you so much, guys, for joining me. Like and subscribe, and in the future, you will see a knife review on the performance of this beautiful, let's just call it 25 centimeter Graphite Series Leszek Sikon Gyuto Wit. I will get a confirmation. I'm just gonna assume, I don't think this is Bog Oak. I'll put it up on screen. I'm gonna ask Leszek what the handle is, and I'll put it up on screen. Thanks again, guys, and see you next time.